checking in again. Lots of things going through my mind. Yesterday I was at the 3C Toastmasters meeting, got feedback about the video, and one issue was the virtual background. Now, I know this background is very, I wouldn't say messy, busy. Busy is the word. And I guess I haven't quite committed, but I've decided I want to get myself that green screen so that I can have a virtual background. The other tip was go to a quiet place where you have a plain white background and stand up in front of the camera. Well, I'm sitting at my desk and the camera is on top of my monitor. I have two monitors. I am a data assistant and I like working with lots of screen space. So my sitting is not optimal, but this is where I am most comfortable, where I spend most of my time, where I'm doing a lot of my video trainings and Zoom meetings and communications and translations and corrections, even telephoning. Where's my handy? Yeah, okay, it's still charging up. It went out this morning. I don't know why, because I charged it overnight. Yes, I just want to talk to you. And as usual, lots of things going through my mind. I'm just grateful for the Toastmasters. It was the 3C Club. It's not my home club, but I helped get it off the ground. As Martin said last night, I was there at the demo meetings to promote it. And there are a few new members there yesterday who didn't know me. And that was nice. It was a good experience. It was a challenge, you know. I'm still really incredibly still fighting with the self-image. You know, I was going to say I'm not a pro. Really? Really? I've been president of the United Nations Club in Vienna twice. I've been area director in Austria, responsible for four clubs. I've received the Toastmaster of the Year award for our district a couple of years ago, 2019, and it came through just after lockdown started, so it was just a virtual award. I didn't get anything. I don't know, there wasn't even a discussion whether I might get a plaque or a certificate or anything at all, but I've got a photo of me with tears in my eyes, typical. And talking about tears, okay, next topic, right? So I'm going to try and monitor a little bit my topics. I just got a message from a dear friend about a friend of hers who died at the age of 55 and has children at home. Pray for her children, was the request. And also this morning, my buddy told me that her girlfriend's husband had killed himself, and actually she's going to a funeral today of another friend of hers. Wow, how precious is life, how we need to appreciate what we have, but perhaps even more reach out, because how hard it is to ask for help when we're hurting, when we're suffering inside. And so I suffer with a self-image problem. I love to listen to people. I'm pushed to do things like this, talk to this funny little camera on top of my computer, on top of my computer screen. And I know I'm talking to you. Even when I don't know who you are, it's in the air. It's in the air. I did a course, another topic. I did a course a few years ago for a tuner, a fork tuner. I don't even know where it is now, but I bought it. And it was a gadget that this lady was using to tune the vibrations in her body, and she was recording videos live and making them available over Zoom, and she was consciously saying that she would include the healing vibrations into that video, so that even if you watched it afterwards, and even the people who had not yet been born when she recorded it, who watched it, could receive the healing through her healing vibrations. It was her consciousness, her healing, her awareness that she is sending out these healing vibes and consciously reaching out to this every individual person. Okay, maybe you say spooky, I say esoteric, I say spiritual, and these are things that were preoccupying me 40 years ago, and at that time I didn't get the impression there was much of a market for it. There were the Children of God and the Hare Krishna and the Transcendental Meditationalists and a few other people that we were aware of. Yet today a lot of these types of messages are coming through to me much more frequently. Maybe it's only the Google algorithms that are bringing them to me, and I'm becoming more aware of it because it's what's preoccupying me. But my impression is that people, you, are much more open to these spiritual realities, these other aspects of life, of the world, of the universe, and the fact that we live beyond our physical lives. Of course, since the passing of my mother 2 months ago, August, September, October, exactly 2 months ago, I'm aware of how solid I am in my own faith, in my own feelings and belief. I know she is there, as well as all of my ancestors and all of those who've gone before us. And right now, when I'm suffering with backache and my knees are not completely recovered, I'm aware of my physical limitations and how important it is to take responsibility for my physical body. And it's also a matter of tuning in and getting my spirit into a high enough vibration that my body can heal. Is this too spooky for you? This is where I'm going. This is where I'm going. I don't know what... I had no intention when I started. I was just meaning to share something. And it's not really the issue of... the self-image is the question. It's not my self-worth. It's the self-image in terms of where do I really want to go? Where do I want to take you, or where can I pick you up? That's my big question. How can I be of service to you? Mm-hmm. How can I be of service to you? I think of my mentors, Todd Furrier, Bob Proctor, Pak Chahan Moon. So many mentors, people who have helped me along my path, and I know that it's so important that we share what we have, that we communicate what we have. And even if it's just showing my face, making a fool of myself to the few people that know me, maybe it will help you to stand up to what you believe, to share what you believe, because think a lot of these issues, especially a lot of the things I'm thinking and feeling right now, are the things that we don't often talk about. And yet this morning I did chapter one again of thinking into results, and Bob says, write down everything that you want, make a shopping list, and then pick out the thing that you want the most, because your C goal has to be the thing, your fantasy, that your A goal is the thing that you know that you can get, and the B goal is the things that you can plan and figure out how to do it. But what you really need for your spiritual growth is the C goal. And it's not a matter of becoming rich and becoming a millionaire and having the money and the boat and the car for their own sake. But when you've got the right C goal, the fantasy that you have that you really want, the material goods will come as a supplement, as a part, as a result of your spiritual growth. And I believe that, even though I fought against the concept when people used to say, well, you bring your own, you're the master of your own fate. In other words, when people got sick or had bad luck, if you told people that they created it themselves, then I would fight against that. But I do believe you can do a lot to help master your fate.